Hi Sagittarians, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com, and this is your monthly forecast for May 2012. We start this month with a lovely full moon in Scorpio on the 6th, and this time the focus is on your diet and your fitness. There seems to be a lot of concern, a lot of effort which has been going on in a lot of you trying to break a pattern in your diet and also in your fitness regime. For those of you who are yet to start running on the treadmill, this is a great time for you to be initiating maybe small walks or maybe changing your diet in a healthy form. It will benefit you a lot. We also have the planet Neptune that moved from Aquarius, where it had been resting for the last 13 years, and it has moved now to Pisces, which is its home sign. And there is some amount of a very subtle effect that Neptune will be giving to all those zodiac signs, depending on the which house is it transiting or which house it is affecting as of now. For you Sagittarians specifically, there seems to be an inability to make a decision regarding a partnership, regarding a relationship, and the planets indicate you may not be having the complete facts before making a call or before making a decision. So do ensure that all the information is there with you, all the facts are there with you, which will help you take a decision. We also have a lovely trine which is there between Saturn and Venus this month. Venus will be making its journey through Gemini, and Saturn is retrograding in Libra, and both Venus and Saturn make a trine. Venus is going to be transiting your 7th house. And if you were to break up the month from 1st to 14th, you'll have the complete planetary support of Venus. But from 14th, Venus starts to go retrograde. So there might be some challenges, there might be some things that you need to look at carefully, there could be some delays. The 7th house covers all forms of partnerships, be it personal, be it at work. So the 1st to 14th, it's a great time to be communicating, to be presenting your ideas, to be dealing with the issues that you've been trying to sort out yet have not managed to. It's a good time till the 14th. Post 14th, it's a time for you to relook, retweak and reconsider the things that you may be doing in a relationship which are not really working out for you, Sagittarians. It's a good time to be having a look at patterns and breaking those patterns at this point of time. In fact, this trend has been carrying on for you since start of March. Also, there seems to be some amount of a mismatched expectations that you may be having out of partnerships, whether it is at work, wherein you may be feeling shortchanged by the projects that you may be doing, or at a personal relationship wherein that you will be, or a lot would be expected out of you and you may not be able to live up to the expectations. So it's a great time for you to be evaluating, re-evaluating and taking a very honest look at it. Sincerity and honesty is the key word for you Sagittarians this month. And you know, while it is alright for people to fool you, but if you keep fooling yourself and that too on a regular basis, it is quite unforgivable and quite foolish, I would say so. So this month, take time and do address these things which needs to be taken care of. We have Saturn that is retrograding your 11th house. The 11th house covers your groups, communities, like-minded people. So again, it is talking of a pattern of the way that you deal with a larger group. And cooperation is the keyword for you over here, Sagittarians. You have to be flexible. You have to be looking at others' perspective, how it is that you deal with larger groups of people, how it is that you present your ideas, how it is that you're perceived. Good news for you. We have a lovely solar eclipse on the 20th May. And during a solar eclipse, the moon passes through Earth and the sun and it forms a perfect alignment. So for over an hour or so, you can't view the sun properly. And this time, the eclipse is happening in Gemini. That is the zodiac for I see, I talk, I communicate, I seek. And since the eclipse is happening over here, there could be some amount of challenges over there. You could feel a bit constrained And it is also forming an angle to Uranus, which is a planet of unpredictability. So it is creating a backdrop for the next 6 months to come, wherein there's a lot of unconventionality, a lot of unusual people will come into your life. You will find yourself working on projects which are not your regular, run-of-the-mill kind of projects that are there. You will find yourself drawn more to maybe spirituality, maybe drawn more to artistic musicians or painters. So your bent of mind, rather I would say for most of the zodiacs, the next 6 months, it is a very unconventional time. Also, I would like to mention that the 2012 is pretty much the trend is setting for the new 60s. This is what the new 60s really is. We have Uranus, which is, like I said, which is making an angle, and this sets off the trend for a lot of personal speech and personal freedom. So there is going to be more stress on entrepreneurship, and there's going to be lesser of a, not a focus I would say, but you would find people speaking up more, you would find more activists, you would find more groups of people who feel very strongly about everything is going to surface. So if you were to look back at 60s, it's going to have, I would say, about 80% of the flavor is going to be there. And since Neptune has moved out of Aquarius after 13 years and it has moved to Pisces, its home sign, Neptune is going to be bringing about its, it has a subtle influence as well. So if you are involved in the creative space, be it editing, glamour, writing, theater, you will benefit greatly. So have a great month. I'll see you again in June. And thank you so much for watching.